A new clash of civilizations is now unfolding before our very eyes. While the atheistic West is in decline, a renewed Russia, based on the Christian faith, the historic church, and cultural unity, whose leader is a devout Orthodox Christian, is emerging as an opposing force to the pernicious spread of Zionist imperialism. It was at the World Economic Forum held in Davos, Switzerland in 2009 that Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin signaled to the Judaic-empowered West that its era of a unipolar world was coming to an end.
Not only the architecture of global finances to be changed, we are talking about the fact that a system based on interaction of a number of major centers should replace a unipolar world.
The demonization of Russia's leader, which I call the Jewish War on Vladimir Putin, then shifted into high gear. The smearing had already begun in 2007, when Gerald Levin's and Norman Perlstein's Time magazine portrayed Putin as a tyrannical monster, as Time's Man of the Year. It all came to a head during the Duma parliamentary elections held in Russia's provinces last month, even before the so-called election monitoring groups issued their reports. U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton had a human rights meeting in Lithuania, accused Putin of rigging the vote.
A number of governments continue to view civil society as adversaries instead of partners. We've just witnessed a flawed Duma election in Russia, including efforts to halt the election monitoring.
Putin was quick to respond, pointing out that Clinton's blatant lie of voter fraud signaled to the Zionist-funded NGOs to begin their staged, well-rehearsed anti-Putin protests.
Нужно вырабатывать формы защиты нашего суверенитета, защиты от, сделала госсекретарь, дала характеристику, оценку выборам, сказала, что они нечестные и несправедливые, хотя еще не получила даже материалы БДИЧ, наблюдателя БДИЧ. Она задала тон некоторым нашим деятелям внутри страны, дала сигнал. Они этот сигнал услышали.
With Jewish chess champion Garry Kasparov at the lead of the protests, complete with a typical and obviously heavily funded. Lots of money here, folks. This is not some spontaneous grassroots protest. Rehearsed theatrics, catchy slogans, and expensive Photoshop posters, some of them pointedly anti-Christian, the shore work of Jews, since the church is very popular under Putin. The leading U.S. State Department-sponsored NGO behind the contrived protests in Russia, as reported by the renowned contemporary historian William F. Engdahl, is the National Endowment for Democracy, known as the NED. This organization has absolutely nothing to do with democracy, but rather with subverting governments that oppose the Zionist West quest for world hegemony through conferences, elections monitoring, and social networking. Dubious beginnings mark this so-called democracy group. You see, the NED's Jewish founders in the 80s, Alan Weinstein and Carl Gershman, were careful to prevent any exposure of the laundered funds coming to them from the CIA, for such exposure would have aborted the organization at its birth. Indeed, the National Endowment for Democracy was created to do overtly what the CIA could not do covertly. Gershman remains the president of the NED, where he is enabled by two powerful money Jews who serve on the board of directors, Kenneth Duberstein, who also serves on the board of the Boeing Company, and Larry Liebenow, former chairman of the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, who now directs the NED's International Policy Center. The Jewish war on Vladimir Putin is now in full bloom. Yet in spite of Jewry's efforts to destroy him, Vladimir Putin, a devout Orthodox Christian, has as his reinforcement troops all the powers of heaven. And of this battalion, fully equipped for lethal battle, international Jewry has no defense.